Honeyminer is the easiest way that I am aware of to mine Bitcoin or really any cryptocurrency from your laptop or your PC. I have been using them for several months now. I should probably check that out before making a video. I've got about 79,000 Satoshis. And let me just show you here. You can think of Satoshis as being like Bitcoin pennies, although there's a lot more of them than when it comes to a dollar. So right now, my 79,000 Satoshis is only 0.00079 of one Bitcoin. So not a whole lot. In today's value, that's only about $5 US. But it is mine. And this here, this program that you download allows you to mine this Bitcoin, and they give you some bonuses as well. So every now and then they give you a bonus. So right now the next bonus is 22 Satoshis. It gets bigger and bigger as it goes along. Sometimes they're bigger than that. I was averaging over 1,000 Satoshis a day. Now it's come down a little bit. I've only got one GPU running. That's on this laptop here. I have another laptop at the office running, and that's only got a CPU in it, and CPUs don't seem to do much. It's the GPUs that seem to really bring out those Satoshis. But it is still a way to do it. This is obviously not a get-rich-quick anything. This is not how you're going to earn a ton of Bitcoin. Nowadays, most laptops and computers can't earn a whole lot, but if all you want is a little bit and you just don't mind it trickling in, this is the way to do it. To get it, first you just hit the download button. You download the app, get it on the computer. Sometimes when you go to run it, your firewall tries to stop it. It doesn't want it running for some reason, and you just have it ignore that particular thing. Tell it to ignore that one. Down here in questions, they have some good things, questions and answers that you might be interested in. One of them is how much you can earn. Well, on my computer, which is about, 4 years old, I don't earn this per day, but, I get a little bit of something, which is okay. And can I choose what coins to mine? See, for those of you who don't know, there's way more than just Bitcoin. Bitcoin is one of thousands of cryptocurrencies. And at this point, they don't let you choose which one, but your mining activity... they're applying your resources of your computer to mine whatever particular algorithm is profitable at that given time. And they're just converting it into Bitcoin to make it easy for you to see. This goes into a wallet for you here on Honeyminer. Honeyminer holds your money, but then you can withdraw it and send it to a wallet that you hold. So, for example, I have a desktop wallet called Exodus, and I hold a few different coins on here. Let's see if I can even show them. And this particular stuff, since it's not stored online, it's stored solely on my computer. It's a little harder for someone to hack in and steal. So once your Satoshis, reach a meaningful amount, you can transfer them out. I haven't bothered to do that. There is a fee of like 2,500 Satoshis that they charge. Now, it's not them. It's not Honeyminer charging that. It is the actual Bitcoin network that charges that. But yes, you can transfer it out. But for me, for right now, forgiven the amounts, nobody's going to steal that. I'm just leaving that in there. This shows you how it trickles in throughout the day. 11 Satoshis, 10 Satoshis, 6, 12, 4. Earlier this week, there was 68, 163, 23, etc. Or never mind this week, that was all today. Now, you might be wondering, what is in it for them? After all, Honeyminer has put together this nice little app that you download, and then you can start mining cryptocurrencies. They're not running a charity. Well, why do they do it? Well, they take a portion of your revenue. It's like all mining pools do. And their mining pool fee tends to be a bit higher than normal, but it's made to run off of your laptops and your computers as opposed to having an ASIC miner. So if you only have one GPU, like I do, they take 8% of your revenue. But if I can only get one more GPU, So if I have another computer with a GPU or just two GPUs, the fee drops down to 2.5. And it doesn't say what they charge for CPUs, but if you only have a CPU, they're probably taking the 8%, but it's not a whole lot of anything because CPUs don't produce a lot. But yes, they take a portion of your revenue, which is, with this, their business model. That's how they stay in business. That's how they pay for them setting this whole thing up. That was their incentive for doing it. Now, they're willing to share it with you and me through their referral program. So if you refer somebody to Honeyminer, they actually share 10% of their Honeyminer's revenue with you. They don't take it out of the profit of the new person who signed up and is starting to mine. They take it out of their very own profit and share it with me because that's cheaper than paying for advertising. They only pay when something goes through, when there's production. They only pay if somebody actually starts mining, right? So that's more efficient than just putting out advertising there. So I can do this, you can do it. We both make the same amount of money when mining, and they share their profit with you. So when I signed up for Honeyminer, I did it using an affiliate link from a guy running a cryptocurrency channel called The Modern Investor, and I used his link to get me started. And so if you would like to mine cryptocurrencies on your laptop or your home PC, then please use my referral link that's in the description below. You can start collecting it, and you can share your own link. You're going to get your own affiliate link. You can share that with other people that you know, and you can get some of Honeyminer's profit shared with you just by encouraging people to sign up, download the app, and start mining. Also, if your friends refer anyone, so if I refer you and you refer someone else, Honeyminer will share 5% of the money you make off of anybody you refer. They'll share 5% with me and 10% with you. So really, they're living on 85% of their profit. Most companies have, probably I was going to say like at least 20% of their revenue going towards advertising. This here is a much more efficient model. They could easily put 20% towards advertising, and they'll get much more bang for their buck because of they're only paying when a deal goes through. See, a lot of advertising is wasted. Think of billboards or flyers. It's not as efficient because you're just scattering it out there. And those still, those cost quite a bit. Sometimes, in stores, they have to pay to get things in a visible location in the store when you're selling your product in a big box store. So this model here is, I'm a fan of this model. And since this is a very cool way to mine Bitcoin on your computer, I thought I would make a video and share it with you. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and I will talk to you next time.